Hi children, how are you? Where? So many children are not submitted your work, not yet. Get ready children. Anyhow, your classes are going to start. By that time, all the work, that means the running notes, notes, homeworks, all you have to submit at that time. Get ready children. Yes. So very good morning to our next class. That is, until now, I have taken for you the physics chapter, that is the force, is it? Yes, force laws of motion. Motion chapter and force laws, Newton's laws of motion, is it? Yes, now let me go for those chapters of the related to physics. Now I am going to take the chemistry chapter, is it? Yes, so today's our chapter is matter around us pure? Is matter around us pure? Okay children, yesterday I went for some shop to buy the provisions. In that I have purchased one cooking oil, but I have cooked with by using of that oil, something odor it is coming children, it's not nice. But on that they have written something, it was pure. What is pure? How much pure? We are not at all knowing about that. And I thought to drink the cool drink. When I opened the lid now, I have seen something inside of that. Is it pure? Oh, I can't. So how can we know that? Whether it is a pure substance or a impure substance? How children? For looking, it will be very good. But if you see inside of that, example, I want to prepare a nice dish by using of the ghee. I thought I want to purchase a ghee. I have taken and came, but that is full of mixture of vanaspati. That is nothing but dalda it has mixed. So my sweet dish is not good. Then what I have to do? If we are giving the money also, we are not getting the pure substance, is it? Yes. So how can we know about that? What is a pure substance? What is a impure substance? This and all we are going to learn in this chapter. Let me start. Are you ready? Yes. Now, here, this one we call it as a mind map. That means the total chapter, what are the concepts we are going to learn? Let me see. Matter. Then the matter is divided into the two substances, that is the pure substance and impure substance. Then pure substance, once again, it has divided into elements and compounds. The impure substance is divided into the mixture. Then mixture, once again, it has divided into the homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Then homogeneous, under the homogeneous we get the solution. Then under the heterogeneous we are going to get the suspension and colloidal. So the total chapter will be covered. So what we call for this? Mind map. Then let me see, what is a matter? Already we have learned, what is a matter? Matter is a pure substance. It is made by the substances, isn't it? Then the matter is divided into the pure substance and impure substance. Then what is a pure substance? What is a impure substance? Let me see now. What is matter? Anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. Example, air, water, sugar. So what is matter children? Anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. Example, air, water and sugar. Then what do you mean by substance? Mixtures are constituted by more than one kind of pure form of matter, known as a substance. So what do you mean by substance? Mixtures are constituted by more than one kind of pure form of matter, known as substance. A substance cannot be separated into other kinds of matter by any physical process. process. So this substance cannot be separated into other kinds of matter by any physical process. For example, sugar and sodium chloride. What do you mean by sodium chloride? It's nothing but our common salt. Okay, so this is about the substance and mixtures. Then in the next class, let me go for what are the types of mixture, then its definition by using of the activity. Okay, children, thank you. Let me see now, what is a pure substance? Any material that is not a mixture. So, if it is not a mixture, we call it as a pure substance. The mixture, if it is not having, we can call it as pure substance. Yes, children, we can call it as a pure substance. And pure substance include elements and compounds. This should be. So, pure substance include elements and compounds. Then, what is the example for the pure substance? Yes, the best example you can go for the pure substance is nothing but water. The example is water. In the water, what is there? The gases. So, oxygen and as well as hydrogen. But we cannot say it is a mixture. Water is a compound. So, pure substances includes elements and compounds. All the elements we can take. Elements means, once again, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, gold, this and all. It comes under the pure substances. Then water, it is a compound. The compounds also, we can take it as the pure substance. Then, blood, children, blood. Is it a pure substance or impure substance? We can say, I am having a pure blood. But inside the blood, so many things we are having. That means the oxygen will be involved, hemoglobin is there, WBC, RBC, then still other things. This more we are getting. That's why it's a mixture. Is it? The blood doesn't come under the pure substance. Then let me go for impure substance. As a material which contains only one kind of atoms, water or molecules, it also named as the mixture. So, as a material which contains only one kind of atoms or molecules, we call it as the impure substance. And this impure substance we call it as the mixture also. The best example is the muddy water. Yes, in the muddy water, we can see there's so many minerals, salts, that and all will be mixed up. So, the example for the impure substance, we can go for it as the muddy water. Next, what is a mixture? What is a mixture? A mixture or constituted by more than one kind of pure form of matter is known as a mixture. Let me take down the definition. And this one you have to take down in your running notes, children. You have to follow that. Okay?